our children. Good day to all of you. Today under unit 2 of materials, we are going to explore on the lesson fiber to fabric. As for me, it's a very interesting lesson. We are all fond of clothes, isn't it? So let's see everything about fiber to fabric, that is clothing. Clothes, along with food and shelter, are primary needs of all human beings. Clothes are used mainly to protect our bodies against the weather, strong sunlight, extreme cold or heat, and rain. Clothes protect us from insects. They also reflect and add to our personality. The kind of clothes people wear mainly depends on the climate of the place they live in and their lifestyle. That is why traditional clothes vary from place to place. Human beings have been wearing clothes since ancient times. They would cover their bodies with leaves and skins of animals. Earlier, clothes were made by hand, and we have evidences of stitching needles made of bones and ivory, which are about 30,000 years old. Can you imagine that? Gosh, 30,000 years old! Today, clothes are mostly made by machines, but handmade clothes are also used in many parts of our country. Now let's go on to the history of clothing. As you know, in olden days, the clothes worn by human beings were made of animal skins and different types of furs. With time, human beings found other materials to make clothes. Clothes were made from the bark of trees and even grass. The bark was pounded really hard to make it soft like pieces of cloth. These soft pieces would be sewn together and then colored with natural dyes. Around 2000 BCE, people finally started to weave cloth. Goodness me, I guess you ought to watch, I mean surf the net and watch a show on weaving of cloth. Got it, children? I want you to do that. Fibers, the thin threads that form a cloth are fibers. There are two types of fibers, natural and synthetic. Natural fibers are either obtained from plants, for example, cotton and jute, or from animals, for example, silk, wool, and fur. Other than these, leather is also obtained from animals. Synthetic fibers are made from materials which are artificially prepared in factories. For example, nylon, terylene, etc. Got it, children? Very good. Now let's go to the plant fibers. Okay, we are going to study in depth about the plant fibers now. Cotton and jute are the main fibers obtained from plants. Now let's see about cotton. Cotton is a soft staple fiber that grows in the form known as a boll around the seeds of the cotton plant. The fiber is collected by either hand picking or by machines. The fiber is most often spun into yarns or threads. The threads are used to weave a soft, breathable fabric. Cotton is the most widely used natural fiber from which cloth is made today. Cotton is used to make a number of textile products. These include terry cloth, used to make highly absorbent bark towels and ropes, and denim, used to make jeans. Cotton is also used to make khadi, a handmade fabric. Socks, in a way, and most t-shirts are made from cotton. Bed sheets are also often made from cotton. Cotton is also used to make yarn, used in crochet and knitting. I love crochet, children. Knitting also I love, but I am I am very fond of crochet. If at all you get a chance, please go ahead and start learning crochet. Got it? It is widely used to make mattresses. Cotton is the first sterilized and used for clinical purposes also. That's when you get hurt. Can you see on the wound, or even before giving us an injection, they start wiping that area? Can you recollect that? So even cotton is used for that, but that is sterilized cotton. Got it? Cotton clothes are most commonly used in areas with tropical climates as they are comfortable in summer. Cotton has been grown in India for thousands of years. Now see children, these are cotton bowls, and I want you to do research here again on cotton variety. You can just come up with anything, you know. You can what you can say. I know, if I was given a chance like y'all, I think I would just go on a cotton journey and just go and see where it grows and what it does and what is happening, you know, and make a full research on that. All right, and then stick pictures or even draw illustrations about it. So interesting. Use watercolor, use paint, make small things. Now this also, if you're really interested, you can really sit and do this painting. All right, first it may come not neat or something, but gradually you'll start neatening, they'll start coming neatness, and you will grow and go far away places then. Okay, what is the activity one telling us here? Visit a tailor shop, select a piece of cotton fabric from the cuttings of the leftover fabrics, pull out a loose thread from the fabric using a pen or a needle, study the way in which the single strand of thread is made. Wow, now this is really, really good activity, children. I want you to do it. You can even, you know, take different sorts of cloth and material and pull out 10 fabric thread from them, the loose thread, and make a study on it. Thin strand, I mean to say, and make a study on it. It would be really enjoyable. Now let's go to the next one, that is the jute. Jute is a long, soft, shiny plant fiber that can be spun into coarse, strong threads. It is produced from the skin of the jute plant stem. It is the second most important plant fiber after cotton. Jute is one of the cheapest natural fibers and is second only to the cotton in amount of produced and variety of uses. Jute fibers are of white to brown in color and 1 to 4 meters long. The fabric made from jute is popularly known as burlap. Jute fabrics are also called Hessian cloth, and jute sacks are also called gunny bags. I like this term, gunny bags, and still now, earlier, I mean, lot of gunny bags were used to store rice and wheat and all. Of course, now they have also changed into other material, but nothing like gunny bag. Okay, jute has also been cultivated in India since ancient times. Indian state of Bengal and Bangladesh, now a separate country, were the major centers of jute cultivation till the modernization of India's jute industry in 1855, when Kolkata became the center for jute processing in India. Jute is used chiefly to make cloths, to wrap bales of raw cotton, and to make sacks and coarse cloth. The fibers are also woven into curtains, chair coverings, carpets and rugs. It is also used to make bags to pack agricultural produce. Jute sacks are also used in packaging industry. Now this is jute plant. Okay children, these are jute plants. Surf the net. Once again I'll tell you, I will be telling you often to surf the net, children, because you will get more information on them, okay, on everything that you learn. Now look at the bales of jute, lovely, aren't they? I love all these things. Jute is 100% biodegradable. It is thus used to make things which could not be made using synthetic fibers. For example, jute is used to make containers for young saplings which can be planted directly with along with the container. The fibers are used alone or are blended with other types of fibers to make twine and rope. Jute butts and coarse ends of plants are used to make inexpensive cloth. On the other hand, very fine threads of jute can be separated out and made into imitation silk. Jute fibers are also being used to make pulp and paper. Jute has many advantages as a home textile in either replacing cotton or blending with it. Now, do you know? Let's see what have we to know. Jute is the most environment-friendly fiber. Jute is the most environment-friendly fiber as it can be recycled more than once. It is called the golden fiber because it has a golden and silky shine. It is the cheapest vegetable fiber that is produced. My goodness, it's known as the golden fiber. Lovely name, isn't it? So children, please, which is known as a golden fiber? Immediately you should be able to tell. Jute is known as the golden fiber, isn't it? Which is the cheapest vegetable fiber that is produced? Jute should be your answer. Alright, now let's go to the next part, that is about the coir. Coir is the fiber obtained from the outer covering of the fruit of coconut palms. Coconuts are soaked in water and then their husk is separated. The husk is then beaten to get the fiber called coir. Coir is spun, dyed and woven. Coir is used to make a number of household products like mats, ropes and floor coverings. They are also used to stuff mattresses and pillows. Now, do you know? A cotton bowl on an average contains more than 5 lakh fibers. Goodness me! India is the largest producer of coir in the world. How very proud am I feeling now being an Indian? Aren't you too, children? Wow! Now we finished with the plant fibers. We are going to go to the animal fibers. Animal fibers include wool and silk. Wool is a fiber obtained from the hair of sheep and some other animals like rabbit, deer, etc. The process of removing wool from the sheep by using special clippers is called shearing. After shearing, the wool is packed in bales. It is cleaned and combed by a machine in mills and then separated and spun into a fiber. This fiber is then woven or knitted to make woolen clothes. Wool is a fluffy fiber and hence retains air. Since air is a bad conductor of heat, wool has the property of retaining heat. Woolen clothes do not allow our body heat to escape and thus keep us warm. Therefore, clothes made from wool are often worn in cold weather. Australia is the leading producer of wool in the world, followed by New Zealand and China. India is among the top 10 wool producers of the world. Other than in clothing, wool is also used to make upholstery, carpets and felt shoes. See these pretty felt shoes? Lovely, aren't they? Gosh, very pretty colors. And they must be quite warm too when you wear them. Okay. Now let's go to after wool, let's proceed further to silk. Silk is obtained from the cocoon of silkworm. Silkworms are insects which feed on the leaves of the mulberry trees. A silkworm secretes a silk thread which it spins around itself. Each silkworm spins a continuous thread up to 800 meters long to make a cocoon. The cocoon is boiled in water to kill the silkworm. Then the cocoon is unwound to get the silk fiber. The rearing of silkworms to produce silk is called sericulture. If anybody asks you what is sericulture, the rearing of silkworms to produce silk is called sericulture. Silk is an expensive fiber. Silk was first used and developed in China about 7,000 years ago. From China, it came to India and then went to Middle East, Europe and Africa. Now let's see what is this. Do you know fact over here? The mulberry silkworm may spin a single thread of about 1.5 kilometers in length. Goodness me. Now find out about, do research about the mulberry silkworm. Got it? Now see, this is the silk cocoon and these are the silkworms. Now let's go further. Silk thread in earlier times was so extensive and important that the major set of trade routes between Europe and Asia were known as the silk route. Many people believe that it is not right to use silk as silkworms are killed in boiling water to obtain silk. Did you get that? Because they have to kill the worms to obtain silk. So people believe that it is not right to use silk. Now it's up to you. Now let's go further to the synthetic fibers. The fibers obtained artificially by chemical processes are called synthetic fibers. Nylon, rayon and polyester are common synthetic fibers. They are made from chemicals that are mainly obtained from petroleum. Clothes made from synthetic fibers are stronger than the clothes made from natural fibers. Now the plus point is they do not wrinkle easily and they dry quickly. But synthetic fibers have less absorption capacity. Therefore, they do not absorb sweat and as a result, fabrics made from these fibers are not suitable for hot and humid weather. These fibers are often blended with other natural fibers to obtain better quality fabrics which have strength and can also breathe air and absorb sweat. Terricot, terry wool, etc. are some examples of synthetic fibers. Now let's go from fiber to fabric. Now this is the main essence, I guess. Now we learned about the different fibers. Now let's see how the fiber helps us to obtain the fabric. The process of converting fiber to fabric involves spinning the yarn. A yarn is then used to make fabric by processes such as weaving and knitting. See here how the yarn is being spinned. Okay, now spinning. The process of making yarn from fibers is called spinning. In this process, fibers are drawn out and twisted. This brings the fibers together to form a yarn. Did you get it, children? A simple device used for spinning is a hand spindle, also called takli. Another hand operated device used for spinning is the charkha. For thousands of years, fiber was spun by hand using simple tools, the spindle and the distaff. Then the invention of the spinning wheel increased the output of individual spinners. Spinning of yarn on a large scale is done with the help of spinning machines. After spinning, yarns are used to make fabrics. Now let's see what is this activity they want us to do here, children. Collect square pieces, that is 2 by 2 inches of different fabrics. Place them on a scrapbook and feel the fabric. Record your observation below each fabric. Now this is something interesting. I want you to do it. Now let's see about this person, an engineer called Hilaire de Chardonnet, who lived from 1839 to 1924. Hilaire de Chardonnet was a French engineer who invented a synthetic fiber. He called his invention Chardonnay silk. He began to develop an artificial fiber in 1878. At first, he made a fiber by squeezing cellulose nitrate through very thin tubes of glass. This fiber burnt very easily. It was highly inflammable. He worked hard to reduce the flammability of the fiber. He displayed his new invention in Paris in 1889. In 1891, he began to produce the world's first commercially made synthetic fiber. Did you get it? Now children, surf the net, find out more details about him, okay, and make a mini booklet about him. Now further, let's go to weaving. Okay, the process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric is called weaving. Weaving of fabric is done on looms. Looms are either hand operated or power operated. In weaving, two distinct sets of yarns or threads called the warp and the filling of the weft and the filling or weft are interlaced with each other to form a fabric or cloth. See, this is the figure here. This is warp and the weft. Now this is the warp yarn and this is the weft yarn. Did you get it, children? Now in depth you have to find out more about it by surfing the net. The warp threads run lengthways of the piece of the cloth and the weft threads run across from side to side. Okay, the manner in which the warp and the weft threads interlace with each other is known as the weave. Woven cloth can be plain in one color or a simple pattern, or it can be woven in decorative or artistic designs. The ancient art of hand weaving along with hand spinning remains a popular craft even today. That's great, isn't it, children? Now let's go further. Knitting. In knitting, a single yarn is used to make a piece of fabric. Knitting is a method by which a thread or yarn is turned into cloth. Knitting consists of loops called stitches, which are pulled through each other. A set of stitches are held on a needle until another loop can be passed through them. Knitting may be done by hand or by machine. There are numerous styles and methods of knitting by hand. See children, this is how knitting by machine is done. All right, now let's see what are the points to remember. Clothes are used mainly to protect our bodies against the weather, strong sunlight, extreme cold or heat and rain. There are two types of fibers, natural and synthetic. Natural fibers are derived both from plants and animals. Cotton and jute are the main fibers obtained from plants. Coir is the fiber obtained from the outer covering of the fruit of the coconut palm. Animal fibers include wool and silk. Wool is a fiber obtained from the hair of sheep and some other animals like rabbits and deer. Silk is obtained from the cocoon of the silkworm. The process of converting fiber to fabric involves spinning the yarn, weaving and knitting. Now let's see some important definitions. Fiber, the thin threads that form clothes. Fabric, material made by weaving fiber. Shearing, the process of removing the wool from the sheep by using special clippers. Sericulture, the rearing of silkworm to produce silk. Spinning, the process of making yarn from fibers. Synthetic fibers, the fibers obtained artificially by chemical processes. Finally, weaving, the process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric. Children, I had a fantastic time. Hope you too had on our journey in this lesson, fiber to fabric. Have a nice day. Thank you.